said for the students of Makere and the community. But when he saw that the university was in the 1-year-long celebration of 100 years, he said, no, God cannot just bring the crusade. Let's believe God. We have a
time and reading the Bible, as I had been brought up in the Scripture Union in my former school, you got to know about faith, like I did from my husband now, who got born again under the Pastor Kayanja Ministries, actually through Pastor Kayanja's preaching. So in our early courtship, our courtship was normally arguments of faith. Me telling him broad life in academics, but also in the spirit. Because Mrs. Nawangwe is very right. We are nothing without the Holy Spirit. And it's time, I don't know what happens in the fellowship now, but it's time to be more interdenominational, Christian interdenominational. Because there are things in life which can only come through stubborn faith and prayer. And there are things in life where you need to draw back, be quiet, and read quietly. There is no contradiction. It's all part of life. I thank you so much for the opportunity. Oh, I should have said, okay, Pastor is a good man, but he really doesn't understand corporate world. Because when he was saying that all the positions were full, the workers were good, so I'm like, okay, his wish is good for me. He's a good man, but really he doesn't understand these things. I can tell you as sure as day and night comes, within months, the first promotion came. And the second came. And I'm waiting for the third. It doesn't have to be the new vision. Please mark that. The third doesn't have to be in the new vision, but I know it is coming. Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Who is my pastor here, and my dear wife, whom I know as Susan, and at home I only know Annie. But today I have heard names I have never heard about. Esther, where did Esther come from? And then Pastor Susan, I never knew she was a pastor. Although I know she is a prayer warrior. I am delighted this morning to host Miracle Center, who actually are our hosts this morning. I would like to thank you, Pastor Kayanja and Pastor Jessica, for honoring Makere University, for coming to celebrate with us 100 years of this great institution. I will tell you a small story which I have never told anybody, but I think I told the Reverend Olesimus quietly sometime. I studied in the former Soviet Union. And one of the things I had to do was to study scientific communism. And I'm actually an expert on scientific communism. And one of the most important things you are taught in scientific communism is that communism will never succeed until the myth of God is removed from the minds of men. In the Soviet Union, if you are seen frequently going to a church, you would be taken to a mental hospital. And the propaganda was so strong that many people actually believed that God is a myth. But I think that is the main reason that led to the collapse of the Soviet Union. Because they were basically fighting God. And of course, for me, it was a little bit of a problem. I'm so proficient in scientific communism, but there is this difficult, you know, ideology against God. And I had been born when I was still in primary school, born again when I was still in primary school. I remember very vividly the pastor who came. I think he was from Kasese. He was a, I don't know the right word to use, but normally we used to call them pygmies. He was a very small man. And they had to put a stool, a platform for him to be seen by the congregation. And he preached the word of God that day. And I had no choice but to get born again that day. Because he repeatedly, every after sentence, he said, Olwalero, urawolubi, Yesu Kristo ayingire. In his accent, from Kasese. And everybody in the congregation that day got saved. So there was this difficult situation for me to reconcile my belief in God, and I had been brought up in a very Christian family with this doctrine that communism would not succeed until the myth of God is removed from the minds of men. So when the Soviet Union collapsed, my mind also settled, because I knew God had taken back his place in the former Soviet Union. And no wonder that now the Soviet Union or Russia is one of the most religious countries in the world. A complete turnover. So the power of God, the power of the Holy Spirit cannot be overestimated. But I cannot say it better than this prayer warrior whom I call Honey. I want to believe that as we enter the next 100 years of Makerere University, we are indeed going to put God first in everything that we do. That we put our trust in God that this university can become even stronger, become even better in the next 100 years. It is therefore very important that we have these activities that are honoring God. As you are aware, we had the interdenominational prayers also on these very grounds about a month ago. And now we are here with the Miracle Center honoring us with the same. I want to thank you, Pastor Kayanja, for making this possible, for honoring us as a university. And as you know, yesterday we had the climax of the celebrations where the president was here, but due to the restrictions, we couldn't invite everybody. But this morning, you have invited all members of staff. And you have catered for everything here. And I'm aware that last night I went to bed when my wife was still working here. And when she came back, she said, Pastor Kayanja is still there himself, carrying the tables and making sure that everything is working. Thank you very much for that.